Hey, what's up, everybody? It's Dallas with Gadget Hacks, and today I'm going to show you how to switch from SuperSU to Magisk and go fully systemless. So I'm sure you guys have at least heard of Magisk, but in case you haven't, let me give you some background. The project was started by developer Top John Wu as a ported version of Exposed that didn't alter any system files, but it eventually evolved into its own thing. Basically, Magisk is a magic mask that does its best to hide root while providing a systemless framework that lets you change things on a root level without altering any files on the system partition. And that's the real key here, systemless. You see, root in a basic sense is simply the ability to access and change the system files that make up Android. But a new Android security feature called SafetyNet can monitor these system files and report to apps when you've modified something crucial. It's a security measure to make sure you haven't changed things in a way that would make DRM apps like Netflix or banking apps like Android Pay compromised in any way. So Magisk works around that by giving you a way to change system files without actually touching anything on the system partition. And there's really two main parts to Magisk. First is a sort of framework that lets you apply systemless mods, which are known as Magisk modules. The second main part is what this video is all about. It's a root management system similar to SuperSU, except that it can hide its existence from other apps. Put these two parts together, and at least for now, you can have root access and perform root level mods, all while SafetyNet is none the wiser. To put it even more simply, this means that you'll be able to run apps like Android Pay and Pokémon GO while you're rooted. But before we get started, there are a couple of exceptions. First, this will almost certainly not work if you're running a custom ROM, because SafetyNet will already trip based on the device certification test. Secondly, the official version of Magisk isn't compatible with the Pixel or Pixel XL, but there's an unofficial version with different instructions that you can read all about if you head to the full tutorial linked down in the description. Aside from that, you'll also need to have TWRP installed. And the last requirement is that you've already rooted using a systemless version of SuperSU. That's basically every root method released in the last year though. So to get started, the first thing you'll need to do is clean up and undo all of your old root mods. If you have Exposed, make sure to uninstall the framework by opening the Exposed Installer app and tapping the Uninstaller button in the Framework section. But don't worry, you can reinstall a systemless version of Exposed through Magisk later. Once you've taken care of that, you'll need to revert any other root mods that you've applied. Basically, if you've changed a file on your system partition, you'll need to put the original file back. So that means undoing any host file ad blocking like you would with Addaway and reinstalling any apps that you removed with Titanium Backup. But again, there are systemless replacements for those root features, and you'll also be fine if you've frozen or disabled system apps without uninstalling. Now, if you haven't kept track of all the root mods you performed, your best bet might be to reflash the stock system image for your phone using Fastboot. Failing that, you may have to completely restore the stock firmware, then reinstall TWRP. But whether you're restoring everything or just flashing the system image, we've got you covered with separate guides at the full tutorial. So once you're sure that your system partition is back to stock, the next thing you'll need to do is remove SuperSU. To do that, open the SuperSU app and head to the Settings tab, then scroll down and find the Full Unroot option. From there, go ahead and tap Full Unroot, then press OK on the first pop-up. Next, it'll ask if you'd like to restore the stock boot image. This is very important, so make sure to tap yes here. Finally, it'll offer to restore your stock recovery image, but you still need TWRP, so make sure to hit no. After that, just wait a little while and your phone will reboot automatically. When you get back up, you'll be fully unrooted. Next thing you'll have to do is install the Magisk Manager app, which you can find on the Play Store. From there, head to the Install section and tap the Download button towards the bottom of the screen. This will save a copy of the Magisk zip, which will be flashing in TWRP. Now, if your phone has already received the May 2017 security patches, you'll have to download an extra zip. This one basically signs the Magisk zip to make it work with Android Verified Boot. You can grab that second zip in step 4 at the full tutorial, so make sure to take care of that if your phone has received a firmware update since May 2017. But with everything downloaded, it's time to flash some zips, so go ahead and boot into TWRP. From TWRP's main menu, tap the Install button, then navigate to your device's download folder. From there, select the Magisk zip first, and if you're running older firmware, that's all there is to it. But if you're on the May security patch or newer, tap the Add More Zips button, then select the Verified Boot Signer zip. Once everything's queued up, just swipe the slider at the bottom of the screen to flash Magisk, then hit Reboot System when that's done. When you get back up, go ahead and open the Magisk Manager app and head to the Settings menu. From here, there are three options that you should enable: Busybox, Magisk Hide, and Systemless Hosts. Once you've done that, head back out to the main menu in Magisk, then tap the SafetyNet check button at the bottom. If everything went according to plan, you should now see three green check marks and a message at the bottom that says SafetyNet passed. If not, there's probably a problem with your system partition, so again, you may need to reflash your stock firmware. But once you've passed SafetyNet, you should now be able to run restricted apps like Android Pay and Pokémon GO. Just to be on the safe side though, open the side navigation menu in Magisk and head to the Magisk Hide section. In here, you can just tick the box next to any of the apps listed, and those apps won't be able to tell that your device is rooted. Aside from that, there's a chance that the Play Store will still report your device as uncertified, which can cause apps like Netflix to not show up. But fixing that should be easy. Just clear data on the Play Store app, then when you head to the Play Store settings, you should see your device listed as certified. At this point, all that's left to do is to replace your old root mods with systemless versions. For the most part, that can be done with Magisk modules, and I've got some of the best ones linked out at the bottom of the full tutorial. So exposed, addaway, and bloatware removal can all be done using Magisk modules, and it won't trip SafetyNet. But keep in mind that if an exposed module alters system files, SafetyNet will be able to see that. And really, that's the key to this whole thing. If you don't mess with system files, you'll keep SafetyNet intact. That means that you shouldn't rename, delete, or alter any files that you would find in the /system folder using a root file browser. But they're not totally off limits, because Magisk modules can alter those files for you, but they do it in a systemless way. So in general, stay away from traditional root mods from here out, and try to replace the same functionality using Magisk modules instead. If you do that, you should be able to run any app that you'd like without having to worry about SafetyNet. And I know this was a lot of information to absorb, but really this video is meant as a companion to the full tutorial. So if you have questions about a specific aspect, it's probably covered in detail over on gadgethacks.com. As always though, we'd appreciate it if you would like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel. So we'll see you again next time, folks, but until then, happy gadget hacking.